So today's a big day. It's finally the wedding. Really excited. Waited so long for this 4-year engagement and it's finally here. So, yeah. Really excited to get to the venue, get to the aisle and just see Alex at the bottom of it and walk towards him.
I can't really tell you how I'm feeling, to be honest with you. I'm a little bit nervous, as you can probably see. Just, yeah, very, very, very nervous, to be fair.
I am really excited for Alex to see me, yeah. He's got obviously no idea what it looks like, so yeah, I think he's going to be excited.
Very excited to see what she's wearing. I've absolutely no idea what to expect at all. Knowing Becky, it's going to be something nice.
White's just not really my colour. So when I was looking for wedding dresses, I was struggling a little bit to try and find the right one. So found this dress and then thought, right, maybe I can adapt it to my style. And then just sort of was, you know, looking on the internet to see what other pictures I can find and then had the idea of adding this lace in. So I found the lace. It's actually a pair of neck curtains. But, you know, seeing it now sewn into the dress, it looks like that's how the dress was always meant to be.
Such a close-knit wedding, there's only 30 people, like every single person there like knows you really well, and I think as soon as you step out in that dress, everyone will be thinking that's a very Becky dress. If you'd come out in like an all-white dress, everyone would be shocked, I think.
Yeah,
if you had like a normal plain wedding dress.
Well, Erin, you haven't seen it before until today.
Yeah.
So when you looked at it, what did you think?
That's definitely Becky's dress.
Knowing Alex, his reaction is probably going to be, he's going to bawl his eyes out.
Have you heard from Alex this morning?
Yeah, because obviously we woke up really early. I texted him just saying that I loved him and he texted me about saying the same thing.
No, yeah,
he's
so cute.
It means the world to finally get married to Alex. Obviously we've been together for almost 9 years, I think it is now. But I think the reason why I'm not nervous is because I know that it's meant to be, so I'm not nervous about getting married to him because I know that that's what's meant to happen.
Well, marrying Beck is everything, obviously. Ever since I've met her, like, immediately I said, I'm going to marry you. That's it.
Right, let's go get you married.
Yay!
Cheers!
So
cute. Looks so beautiful.
You do, gorgeous. Let's go get married. With the roof right over
our heads, we'll share the shelter. With the roof right over our heads, we'll share the shelter.
Treat you like a man is supposed to. You'll never have to cry. No, I know everyone can relate to when they find a special someone. And she's royal, yeah, so royal. And
was kind. Christ. No, the way she moved to our own beat. She had.
Ladies and gentlemen, what a beautiful entrance. Should we have a round of applause there for our friend? I think I can speak for Alex and say, wow. If everybody could please be seated. Do you want to move a little closer before you get yourselves married?
Okay.
Well, good afternoon, everybody. I would like to welcome you all here today on behalf of Liverpool Register Office. It's my pleasure to be guiding you both through your ceremony and your marriage vows here today. So, ladies and gentlemen, family and friends, you are all here today to witness the marriage of Becky and Alex, as they exchange their vows of marriage, which will unite them as husband and wife. Becky and Alex wish to marry, for in each other's company they have found friendship, happiness and love. And they now wish to publicly affirm this relationship, to offer to each other the security that comes from legally binding vows, sincerely made and faithfully kept. Marriage is also a commitment by two people to share themselves and their experiences with each other. They must be willing to accept one another for who they are, their strengths and weaknesses, their hopes and fears, and their different views and wishes. When two people love and care for each other, they create a spirit unique upon themselves, which binds them closer than any spoken or written words. I can see that in your faces today. This is a deep and lasting commitment, and it should not be entered into lightly. So before I ask each of you to make those formal declarations, I do need to check, as if we have any doubts, that we're marrying the right people to each other. So if you could please, first of all, Robert, give me your full name.
Yeah, Robert Alexander Joseph Fordry.
Thank you.
Rebecca Sarah Hamer.
Thank you.
If
there is any person here who knows of any lawful impediment why these two people should not be married, they should declare it now. Very well behaved guests. As I have said, any union that you enter into has to be done voluntarily. So I ask each of you therefore this question. Do you, Alex, by your own choice, enter into the union of marriage with Becky?
What do I say? I do.
And do you, Becky, by your own choice, enter into the union of marriage with Alex?
I do.
So I'm now going to ask each of you in turn to declare that there is no lawful reason why you should not be married to each other. And then you will exchange the words by which you will become husband and wife together. So it is tradition for our groom to speak first during the ceremony. So if you could please repeat after me.
Try.
I declare.
I declare.
That I know.
That I know.
Of no legal reason.
Of no legal reason.
Why I, Robert Alexander Joseph Fordry.
Why I, Robert Alexander Joseph Fordry.
May not be joined.
May not be joined.
In marriage.
In marriage.
To Rebecca Sarah Hamer.
To Rebecca Sarah Hamer.
No pressure. I declare.
I declare.
That I know.
That I know.
Of no legal reason.
Of no legal reason.
Why I, Rebecca Sarah Hamer.
Why I, Rebecca Sarah Hamer.
May not be joined.
May not be joined.
In marriage.
In marriage.
To Robert Alexander Joseph Fordry.
To Robert Alexander Joseph Fordry.
Marriage is the blending of two people on the same path in life. On this path, they have many challenges along the way. But from today, you will face them together in a partnership based on trust and love. I will now invite you to embark upon this journey with each other by making your marriage vows to each other. So these words are not said to me or to your guests, they're said to one another. So you want to face each other a little bit more.
I'll try. No, I'm all right now.
And at this point, if I could ask people to stand. Thank you.
I, Robert Alexander Joseph Fordry.
Take you, Rebecca Sarah Hamer.
Take you, Rebecca Sarah Hamer.
To be my wedded wife.
To be.
You got it.
My wedded wife.
There you go. I choose you.
I choose you.
As the person.
As the person.
With whom I will spend my life.
With whom I will spend my life.
I, Rebecca Sarah Hamer.
I, Rebecca Sarah Hamer.
Take you, Robert Alexander Joseph Audrey.
Take you, Robert Alexander Joseph Audrey.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
I choose you.
I choose you.
As the person.
As the person.
With whom I will spend my life.
With whom I will spend my life with.
Yes, I'm
so
much
guys,
better
you
than
can
it
relax
was.
A little bit now. We come to that very special part of your marriage ceremony, and this is the giving and receiving of your wedding rings. This is a traditional way of sealing that commitment that you have just made to each other. So at this point, I'd like to invite our special ring bearer, Gina, to step forward with our two glamorous assistants, Erin and Rosie.
Hi, Gina.
It's absolutely ridiculous.
Hello, Mrs.
Hi, you okay? Hello.
Can't believe that actually worked. It's unbelievable.
Thank you, Gina.
So first of all, this is where you bring your own glasses in. So
yeah.
We could take out Becky's ring first.
Yep.
And put that onto Becky's finger.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Now, a couple have written their own vows to each other today, so I'm going to take a step back here and I'm going to...
Oh, is it my turn?
Yeah. Vows. Oh, okay.
Does that... Oh, where's your wedding ring?
Yes, there.
Left hand, third finger.
Yep, this way.
Other way.
Yeah. That way.
Nice on to your wife's hand.
Do I do this now? I promise to always bring you G&Ts in the bath to uncurl your socks before going in the wash and tell you that you look great whenever you're getting ready. I will always agree to adopt just one more chihuahua and build just one more shed to house that one last tortoise. There isn't one day that I don't love you more than when I woke up.
Aww. Thank you.
Just got you on your phone.
And if you could please
I promise to always be your best friend. I promise to rave with you till the very end. I promise to always be in your team, and I promise to always know all the words to Queen. I promise to annoy you more than anyone else, but that's only because I know you better than you know yourself. I promise to always make all your worries go away, even when a virus pandemic comes and cancels our wedding day. I promise to really try not to put the dirty spatula on the clean worktop, but I also promise to be sorry because inevitably it's going to happen a lot. But most of all, I promise to love you the way that you've always loved me, unconditionally and for affinity. I love you.
Yep. Your wedding rings are an unbroken circle and they symbolise unending and everlasting love. They're an outward sign of those lifelong promises that you have made to each other today. Wear these rings as a memory of all your yesterdays, a reminder of today, and a promise of everything that the future will hold you both. May your hands be forever joined in friendship and your hearts forever joined in love. So Becky and Alex, you will be pleased to know that you have now made all the declarations required by law. You have entered into a solemn and binding contract with each other in the presence of your family and your guests.
Can't get out now.
Ridiculous.
Your wedding day marks the start of a new period in both of your lives. You are demonstrating complete faith in each other. Let the world know that you are now husband and wife. And may you face the years ahead, knowing that whatever life may hold, you can share it through the strength that your marriage will bring. Thank you so much. It has been a pleasure and a privilege for me to do the ceremonies today. And it therefore just gives me very great pleasure to now announce that you are lawful husband and wife. Would you like to?
It's all
suppose, but it's surreal, isn't it, that it's actually happened? We're actually married. It's happened.
It's the same as before.
It is the same, isn't it?
It's just a ring. I wanna love that warmer than the summer sunshine. I wanna love that warmer's mine because my love.
What a day. It's just been a really nice experience seeing her walk down the aisle in that lovely looking dress, and she just looks fabulous. So we're all just really pleased.
I don't want no ice cream, love, it is too
cool. Well, I think you can kind of gather from what I look like, how I felt when I first saw Becky. I couldn't really say anything, to be honest, apart from some rude words. I'm a lot better now, though. A lot better. I was very nervous.
Oh, the tears. Oh, my gosh.
Yeah, no, it took a lot to not well up. Yeah, we were in our makeup, but we were both sat there like,
breathe.
Yeah, it was great. And that is
why I see. As a mum, it's your dream, isn't it, to see your daughter walk down the aisle. And I could see everyone else looking at her and thinking how wonderful she looks. I'm more than pleased with the dress. I think she looks tremendous. I think it's really unique, which is what she wanted. Nothing that anyone else will ever have. But it still fits the occasion. It still looks like a lovely wedding dress. So she looks fabulous.
The dress is 100% Becky-fied, and I could tell with his reaction and everyone else's that it's as soon as everyone saw it, they were like, yeah, that's it, that's the one.
Yeah, no one would have guessed it was that material. It just looks like it's part of the dress, doesn't it?
Yeah, it literally looks like an extension of the dress. Yeah. Not that Becky's been online and bought a £2 for
£3.
Probably
£3. I did say to her, surely that won't work. But in the end, I think most people will agree it looks absolutely fantastic. So I think she's really seen the vision, and it's worked perfectly.
Say it again, I say my love. Jean is my tortoise, and I've had her since before I met Becky, yeah. So she had to be a part of the wedding day, obviously, because she's my little baby, I suppose.
OG.
OG, yeah. I say the love in the winter should be warmer
than the summer sun. I think even as a married couple, our life, we're already at like a married couple, don't we?
It's not going to change much other than
we're just going to crack on. It's just the end. Yeah.
That's about it, really.
Today is just the end of a long journey. And her dad and I are just so proud of the two of them because they make such a lovely couple, and we were just desperate for them to get married. So this is just a really fabulous occasion for the whole family.
Go on then, give the
Here
smile.
We go again, get ready to light your lips.